Alan, all of these big gospel artists. I was 18 at the time. They barely knew me. All they knew was that I had media aspirations. It had to be God. It had to be God to touch their heart to say, give this girl a chance. And look, like I said, sincere intentions. I didn't go there. I didn't even know that there was opportunities to interview these people. But again, I was sincere. I just wanted to help. And so that's really the heart that we must have when we talk about living intentionally, being sincere and really not wanting or thinking that we get anything in return. Just to have a heart of willingness that God, no matter what happens, you bless it. And so that's the key takeaway from Ruth and Naomi. So drum roll number two. I'm not here, I'm not getting drum roll. Gotta make sure all y'all fill up. The second one is Hannah. So imagine being barren and every day being tantalized by your husband's other wife who has children. Now that could cause jealousy, bitterness, all kinds of stuff. But guess what? You know what Hannah chose to do? She chose to pray. Pray and pray and pray amongst what she was being faced with. And that's the challenge to us. When we're walking this road of being intentional, there's some times when we just have to go on our feet and give it to Jesus. Because us in our human way, we can't. But your challenge may be finances or on your job or your children. Lay it at the feet of Jesus. We see what Anna did. And guess what? She was blessed with a son. But she was consistent. She taught us the power of intercession. And that's really what we must do when we're trying to live an intentional life. We have to consistently be on our feet in the good and the bad. Because you know we run to Jesus when things bad. Oh Lord, I love you and I'm there and all that. But even in the good times and even in the bad, we must be consistent in our prayer and our worship. And so can anybody give me the name of the son that she was blessed with? This one right here was the first one, girl. Yes, so the son was Samuel. So we have some people listening. The third one is, drum roll, Esther. Sister Rose sounds like she loves Esther. Okay, so Esther teaches us that being intentional isn't always about us. When Mordecai went to Esther with the news that the king's right-hand man, Haman, had planned to kill the Jews, Esther was reluctant because although she was the queen, she did not have any right to lay her case before the king without an invitation. This act could be a death. So I have a question. How many of you would go before our governor general without an invitation? It's serious, because you know, like, when she's in her chair, you cannot sit there unless you're invited. And so Mordecai convinced Esther that she may have been brought into this position to be led and save her own people. And remember now, Mordecai just didn't come out of the sky. Mordecai was a relative of Esther. She helped to raise her. So he helped to raise her. So she agreed to go before the king without an invitation, even if that meant death. So the king came over and she was able to tell him what was about to happen. And guess what? Long story short, the plans that Haman had for Mordecai his plot. And so we see in Proverbs 26:27 where it says, whoever digs a pit will fall into it. If someone rolls a stone, it will roll back on them. So listen, when you're living intentionally, you have to have your intentions right, because we see the same trap that he planned, it became his very own. And so Esther demonstrated courageousness and a heart of service. First, she was courageous because she was willing and intentional to go before the king, even if she would mean that, it would mean that. Second, a heart of service because she was advised that she may have been put into this position to save all the people and bring change. And my question is, how many of us are put in positions right now to bring change and we're not rising to the occasion? That was the thought that came to me as I prepared for this, and even for myself. What can I do more in my life to be a light for God? Because in Colossians 1 and 16, it says, for him all things were created through Christ and for him. So we're not just here to be here. We're moving, breathing, all because of Jesus. And so, one, Esther demonstrates courageousness, and two, she demonstrates a heart of service. And so now we're going to do a quick recap. So who was the first lady I spoke about? Okay, who was the second? And who was the third? All right, so y'all listening. So moving right along, number four, the five daughters of Zelophehad. Now that's, you know, sometimes these Bible words get a little hard sometimes. So this story is very unique because it talks to the fighter in us. These five daughters were living in a time where women were to be silent and out of sight. However, they had no situation. They wanted their father's inheritance. And so they had to go before the big bosses of that time. But the sisters, they faced fair face on. They went before those men and they did what they were technically not supposed to do. They spoke and they were in fight. And guess what? Their determination brought victory. They changed the hand of history in that time forever, now enabling daughters to receive their father's inheritance. Being intentional sometimes will cause you to jump into some deep sea. Jump into the water. That's what it is. We have to take risks all the time. Usually when we look at history all the way, it was because somebody took a chance. Sometimes we won't know what the end result is. But when you take a chance, you take that risk, you jump into the deep, especially if you know it's ordained by God. If I know God that way, because he will be my life best, right? And so we see that with these five daughters. Drum roll, we're going on to number five. We're getting there. All right. Now I want to feature Maya Angelou. I have great respect for her. Her story is inspiring. It's uplifting. Her poetry speaks to your inner being. At age 7, she was molested by her mother's boyfriend, and she told her brother. A few days later, the attacker turned up dead, killed allegedly by one of her uncles. She believed her words had killed the man, so she stopped speaking for 5 years. You know what it is not to speak 5 years? I don't know what it is not to speak for like 2 minutes. But you know what? Maya used that season of her life to spark her writing. And through that pain, it birthed an amazing writer, poet, and author. And yes, bad things happen, and we don't want these bad things to happen, but what if that didn't happen? And so that's why we can't question God and the way life ends up. Because when we see Maya's story, she rose up. She didn't let her past and that pain hold her back. And I think that's sometimes what we do. When these bad things happen, we just stay stuck and we don't move forward. But these things happen to help us to go forward, not to stay stuck. All right, so I want Joelle to share one of my favorite poems by which says, "Still I rise." I think this is my shout out to all the women in the house. Still you will rise.
You may write me down in history with your bitter, twisted lies. You may trod me. I rise. That's my sassiness of Satan. Why are you beset the gloom? Cause I walk like I've got oil wells pumping in my living room. Just like moments and like suns, with the certainty of tides. Just like hopes springing high, still I rise. Do you want to see me broken?
Bacardi. And this is what people thought was crazy. make sure it's God. And that was a hold. Make sure it's God. Whatever decision, whether it's transition, anything, make sure it's God. And sometimes it's hard to know because you could confuse what you think is to be God and all of that. But sometimes I always say this jokingly, but like, God, come down for real and just show me so that I can go forward. And so, yes, that's my key takeaway from Dr. Barbara. Truly, it would be my mother, Katherine. When I look at my life, and as I was preparing, I was thinking, who and what would have been my first example of leadership? And when I think, it's my parents, you know, because I know my dad would say, what, who mentioned me? What? I feel like I go home tonight. It was my parents. But because it's a woman, but when I look back, I see she was really planting seeds of ownership in my life. And ever since then, anything, any kind of thing I do, she said, Katherine, we will trust you as long as you keep our trust and faith in you. And I appreciate that with them. Both of my parents, they don't stress me out, I don't stress them, or we, you know, as in any children and parent relationship. But it's okay because I have the understanding that once I stay in the line of God and I stay in my place, like my mommy always say, don't shame me, don't shame me, you know, things will be okay. And so I also talked to one of my brothers and I was like, you know, what is something empowering about mommy? And one of them had said that he remembered when he was off to school and he was trying to decide that he was going to stay. And he said, she told him, if you want to stay, because we didn't get you straight with your first degree, that's on you. And he said it really caused him to man up and take responsibility for his life. So I realized that it wasn't only me who saw and respected her for that. It was throughout my brothers as well. And so, mommy, I thank you for planting those seeds in me that have truly grown and flourished throughout my life. So let's give it up for my mother. Do a quick recap, all right? So, do I let you do on your feet? So, from Ruth, we learned I need one volunteer and I want to learn what was the key thing I said about Ruth. From Ruth, we learned
tensions.
Woo! Perfect! From Ruth, we learned to be sincere with our intentions. And I mean, she has it exactly how I have written. So, she was really listening. From Hannah, we learn. Sister Cynthia.
Consistency.
Consistency, that's one of the points. But what was one of the key things? You give us. But I still want the key thing that we learned from Hannah. Yes, the power of prayer and intercession. From Esther, we learn. Right here, my friend from Lee University. From Esther, we learn.
Courage and service.
Yes. The five daughters of Zelophehad, we learn. Somebody on this side.
Their determination changed history.
Their determination changed history. From Maya Angelou, we learn.
Still I rise. Still I rise. That has so much in it. Who said that?
Sister Joyce.
Why are you getting any exercise?
From Dr. the best use of the time.
because the days are evil. Therefore, do not be foolish, but understand what the will of the Lord is. I want to highlight, look carefully then how you walk, not as unwise, but as wise. And really, when we look at intentional living, we talk about sincerity, we talk about courageousness, we talk about taking risks and just launching out. But guess what? The fundamental of that all is Jesus Christ. And he has to orchestrate it, he has to ordain it. And any plan, any dream, any aspiration we have, if he doesn't ordain it and bless it, it won't work. It will fall apart. And so I am challenged, and I am also challenging you to live an intentional life. With Jesus, we can. We can rise like Michelangelo in the midst of whatever storm comes before us. Jesus can walk with us. He talks with us. He moves with us. He's present. All we have to do is speak and reach out to him. Speak and reach out. And so, I just want to close out with a quick prayer. And we will be on our way. Dear God, I just thank you for this night. I thank you for this gathering. I thank you for this opportunity to share what it is that you have put on my heart to share as it pertains to intentional living. God, I just thank you for every woman gathered in our midst. You know each one of them by name. God, you know their hearts. You know their desires. You know the call that you have on their lives, God. Lord, speak to that right now, God. Any woman that is feeling discouraged or feeling like they're losing hope or don't know where to go or where the next dollar is coming from or where the next opportunity is coming from, God. Lord, give them the comfort, God, the direction, God, the hope in you that you will supply all of their needs, God. God, that you will never leave or forsake them, God. That you will walk with them, that you will stand by them. Even when it doesn't feel like you are there, God, help them to know that you are there, God. Lord, bless them. Bless everything that is attached to them, God. Lord, their families, God, their friends, God. Lord, any plan of the enemy, God, we cancel it right now in the name of Jesus, God. And we say that these women will rise, God. Lord, they will rise. They will be intentional, God. They will serve you wholeheartedly. They will live for you wholeheartedly, God. They will do everything it is that you have called them to be and do, God. Lord, we thank you for what you are doing here tonight and what you will continue to do through this conference. We bless you. We thank you. Amen.
Which was Sister Barbara Williams, because when growing up, Sister Dawn, I wanted to preach.
marriage license, mom. So she really impacted my life when I was about, perhaps about 14 years ago. But I know now that God has called us each differently. We have to walk in the calling that He has called us to. But Sister Barbara, she is a living legend. All right, Mel, come now. Just we're leaving. We're going to leave, but she's just going to let us get in.
Everybody stand, grab your neighbor and say, we had a good time. Come on, grab your neighbor and say, that was awesome. There's a song that my children's choir sing. It says, we're walking in power. I'm a working miracle. I know who I am. That's it. I know who I am. Wave your hand if you know who you are. If you're intentional. My gracious. Come on, now, y'all gotta do a little action because, you know, we wait until they come down. We don't wanna be a little stiff, so the singers can sing and we can move.
We are a chosen generation, called to show His excellence. All I require for life God has given me, I know who I am. We are a chosen generation, called show His excellence. All I require for life God has given me, I know who I am. We are a chosen generation, called for to show His excellence. All I require for life God has given me, I know who I am.
She is praying. Wonderful. Again, the session up there is rather hot. So let me just recap what took place down here, and then we will close out from the main sanctuary. Daughters of the King, as we depart these four walls, let us depart knowing that we have gathered valuable information on how to effectively communicate, how to be intentional about our living, and also how to lead and train. Let us remember to sharpen the saw in word, prayer, and in our actions. Let us know that as a mother knows the cry of her baby, the communication channel that her baby uses to send a message, whether hungry, sleepy, or comfort needs to change. So does our Heavenly Father in heaven know every cry or groan we communicate, and He will be there to guide us along the way. He knows our verbal and non-verbal communication. And let us develop relationships that will last a long time. Positive relationships, encouraging one another to lead in the things of God. Just pick up the phone to call a sister to say, let's spend time together in prayer. Let's have tea time. That is fellowshipping. That is authentic fellowshipping. Share the joy and love. Be intentional and be a witness for Jesus. And when you spread your love and joy, let the tone be one that the Master says yes to. Truly, she is my disciple because of her love. Express love in different tones, whether it's a touch, whether it's a word, or whether it's through giving. And most important, lead by example. Represent the image of Jesus and the kingdom that you belong to. Time will not be here forever, but what we do with our time is all that matters. At the end of this journey, we want to hear, well done, thou good and faithful servant. And then remember, nothing can be done once you're in the grave. So let us leave out to be intentional about being a witness, to live a life of purpose, and to do what God has called us to do. Let us stand. I am going to ask Sister Edna to come and just close the session out in prayer. Please do not forget to fill out the evaluation forms and visit the university table at the back. I'll bring the mic to you. You can close this out.
Let us pray. Father, we give you thanks for all that has transpired here this evening. We thank you, God, for the worship. We thank you, dear God, for the centers. We thank you, dear God, for everyone in attendance. And we pray, God, that whatever has been said and done, that it would be applied to our lives. We pray, God, as we go to our several homes, that you will keep us safe. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you very much, Sister Nina.